here for round one. Playing blue, white, red familiars. Already wasted a minute and a half setting up the stream, but hopefully this is a fast pairing. Blue.
Preordain.
If it's fairies, I want this faithful. If it's not fairies, I think either way, I don't want the snap. But I'll take the faithful. We'll just assume it's fairies leading off with blue. I think it's mono blue fairies. Getting some Moldrifter or Preordain here. I think I'm just going to evoke Moldrifter and make him have the hard counter. And I could have just delayed. Probably should have delayed, actually, now I think about it. Should have waited next turn and then I could Preordain, bait out the Spell Stutter, but I guess I'm not punished for it, so there's that. Alright, cool. More Touring Miners, good draw. Really don't want these Strands against a blue deck. It's kind of awkward. Alright, well, Jugglebog makes the Mortuary Mire less good, obviously. Maybe he's like a Teachings variant or something? Let's just run out Seagate. One Mortuary Mire if he counters it. Yeah, he must be on some kind of a teaching stack. Or like a blue-black control, some variety. Yeah. Alright, well, I like the odds against blue-black control decks, so. Just got a lot of card draw. Preordain first, see if we can get a familiar. Nah, I don't need either of these. I guess I'll take another Preordain. This is probably his Moldrifter turn. Maybe not. Alright. Let's get another island turn on our Mystic Sanctuary. Maybe he'll counter God Pharos. Yeah, I didn't think he would, but gotta try.
Your home is important. That's why Geico helps.
Still don't need either of those. Alright, even else is perfect. Just a place. Home is where you build a giant pillow. This little sanctuary put on, put Preordain on top. And room, cast even analysis.
And when they ask what kind, you say chocolate lab? And weave a web of lies that's almost as intricate as the crown molding in Fort Pillow. The Geico Insurance Agency could help protect the pillow soft fortress you call home. Call Geico and see how easy it is to switch and
save. Alright, if he has another bog, it'll be insurance. Really, really annoying. Oh yeah, no, he bounced the bog. That's annoying. Alright, well, I got a Preordain on top, at least. Given the brainstorm. Yeah, I want to put both of these on top. Because I'm going to cycle away strands. Both these strands. Oh, yeah. play out the mountain. Hoping he does like a teaching right here. No? That's annoying. That sucks. Okay, cool. Gives me an opportunity to resolve this. Oh man, he has a disc. That's so fucking annoying. Maybe I shouldn't have kept Ash Brains on top. I just assumed I'd be able to resolve Brainstorm. Alright, well, need a deep analysis. Okay, I guess I'll just keep on drawing lands. God, him out in that dispel. Okay, sure. I'll discard my strands. I think he's gonna win this game because I just got nothing going on. We'll chain a couple of deep analysis together. But he's got seven cards in hand now. Oh, he had a very, very good draw. Combined with my misplays, obviously. Faithful's not what I want. So I drew all my anti-aggro cards too. That also hurt a lot. I'm gonna prohibit like literally anything does, so. Or maybe not. Yeah, Sage's Road doesn't do anything here. Maybe I should have played it out in case he has a bog, but I don't know. Oh, sure. You can Doomblade my Faithful. I don't care about that. Alright, Flicker does literally nothing. I mean, I got a lot of turns to go still. I could still do some deep analysis chain shenanigans. I got the Flicker for... Yeah, Sunscape. I'm not gonna jam that out yet. I need yet. Yeah, I probably should have prohibited Augur. No, I need to save my prohibits for it to counter, get stuff through. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Alright, cool. There's deep analysis. Let's lead off with that. Suppose we can play a Seagate. I get surprised, that's fine. Just jam out another deep analysis. Which I assume will also get countered. No? Cool. Alright, that's fine. That's not a bad turn. Block this auger and go down to 3 and hope to snap the angler. Alright, cool. Another prohibit's a great draw. Alright, so let's turn off the Sunscape and fight over it. Oh wow, nothing? I was really expecting to have to fight over that one. Alright, well. Guess let's snap the angler. Bait with Seagate. Okay. I evoke, flicker, and then I can prohibit twice. So we know he's got another deprive. No, he's got a counterspell too. That sucks. Now I'm just gonna do it. Just run him out of the counterspells. Jeez, he had counterspells too. Alright, well he's got it, so he's got an angler, a deprive, and something else. I don't want either of those. Cool. Deep analysis, great draw. One mold drifter. He gets another. Not a big deal. Okay. Oh shoot, I should have blocked this guy. Whoops. Trade off deep analysis. It's debatable to play the faithful first. Yeah, leading off the faithful there. Cast deep analysis, trying to bait out the deprive. Didn't quite work. I guess let's just get the deprive out of his hand. And I'll prohibit that. How did he let that through? Does he not have the deprive anymore? It's weird. That seems like something new. I don't know what's going on here. Just gonna chump the angler and let the mole drifter through. Okay, sanctuary gets back. Deprive. He must have used the deprive, I just didn't mark it. Alright. So he has one card in hand, which means that I play the Sunscape, I prohibit his counter, and I win. Okay, cool. Alright, so definitely want these red elemental blasts and negates, I think. Don't think I need faithfuls. I definitely don't need prismatic strands. So then maybe I can just put in two remove souls. Yeah, that seems good. He's got mole drifters and augers and anglers. Mulligan. This one's capable. Send back snap. Lead off the wilds, fetch an island, and then with the ash barrens, fetch plains. Actually, I should do that in reverse. Fetch the plains first, the wilds. He missed with auger, which is good. Oops. The island, dig for land. I don't think I want to see a gate oracle. I've got a deep analysis and a mole drifter. I don't need more card draw. Yeah, he had a really good draw and managed to come back from it, so I was going to concede there for a second too, so lesson learned, don't concede. Alright, well, it takes either my deep analysis or my snap. I don't particularly care which one he takes. I'm perfectly okay with either. Probably the right move to take the snap. We only got two cards in hand. I'm just going to jam out Sunscape. Next turn. If he has like an Edict or Doomblade, it's fine. Doesn't matter. Okay, Evoked Muldritcher is perfect. Exactly what I wanted to see. Well, not exactly. But it's good for me. I can get another Sunscape out. And play my land and say go. Or can cast Deep Analysis. I like getting out the Sunscape while his counter magic isn't open. This is worse if his hand is like mono removal, but better if it's counter spells. This also gives me an opportunity to, if I draw an island next turn and then deepen out, and then a flicker or something, then I just win. I think we're gonna go deep analysis first. Don't need white mana. Alright, so there's the island. Play that preordain. Digging for a flicker now. Brainstorm the wilds. Can I afford to keep both? Because what do I want to shuffle away? I want to shuffle away like this mountain. I'm going to bottom the wilds and top the brainstorm. Just deep analysis. Alright, there's the flicker, so and the negate, so next turn we can just win. Oh no. Alright, well, let's protect the flicker. That sucks. No, he's gonna get it. That's fine. Took the negate? Alright. I guess he's planning on countering with flicker instead. Alright, I'll play the Denizen. See if he takes the bait. He didn't. Okay, so then we're just gonna wait until we draw another Drifter or Counterspell. Him looping open 3 open mana means that he probably has an exclude. Sunscape's free. Take five. It's fine. Well, everything's gonna be free.
Hey, you feeling better? Well, you're not going to school today.
I decided to leave you home.
Your mom wrote me a note how you were feeling that last.
Yeah, well, you are, because I decided to leave you home. Right, take another five. I mean, at some point, I can just start chump blocking. Alright, cool. I think that basically means we're going to win here. Alright, yep. Got the other. Got a prohibit. Might as well just do another deep analysis. Alright, cool. So we got the Mole Drifter. Let's evoke it. He's gonna counter, I'll prohibit. He didn't counter, okay. Oh wow, he even drew more counter spells? That's pretty sweet. This is going to be a win. I'm actually going to snap. I want to snap, yeah. Going to snap the angler. Get two blue mana and then negate his dispel. I probably should have prohibited it. Doesn't matter. Alright, cool. Match one down. For match two. Oh, anybody here yet? Anybody here? Nobody's here. A couple people here. Cool, cool. Here, shout out. Here's the deck. Pretty cool. Decided to go with a no Karu version. Splash in red for mostly for Gorilla Shaman because Affinity is a terrible matchup. But we also get to play this like red elemental blast and then scattershot. Scattershot's sweet against fairies. And it's also like marginally good against weenie aggro decks. Alright. Who are we up against this time? Riki Beholder. I don't know what they're on. And is unkeepable. Maybe keepable if there's a white source, but. Having a Sage's Row and two Strands against an unknown, I don't know. We're gonna mulligan that. And if Brainstorm was like a Ponder, I would keep this, but we're gonna mulligan this too. Alright, that's keepable. We'll send back a Flicker. And I'll just snap. Alright, against Affinity. Which is, I don't have the best starting hand for Affinity, but maybe we'll get there. Preordained Sunscape. I'll keep both those. Can't cast the Sunscape till next turn, but or till turn three. I And he's got, I think, the best start that Finny can have against us. Alright. Now we need to dig for the snaps. Ooh. We'll take another familiar, though. And this is just going to fetch planes. As long as he doesn't go like frogmite, mirror enforcer, we're good. Okay. Doesn't look like this happening, that's good. We've got like two more turns to set up before I'm dead. Oh shoot, I didn't fetch my planes. Well, that was a big mistake. That might have cost me the game. Oh, fuck! Wow. That is going to cost me the game. That is definitely going to cost me the game. I meant to cycle that. If he does, like, anything here, I'm just going to concede. Like, I think if he just plays anything, I lose. Yeah, well, that's good enough. I can't handle that. Okay. Well, obviously, huge misclicks. But we've got a good sideboard for them. A red blast, we don't blue blast. Strands comes out. Denizen, I suppose. I think I want remove souls. I want nature's chance. Seagull Oracle's probably not good enough. Cut a brainstorm. Cut a flicker. You make two more cuts. Maybe it's just a deep analysis and a snap. Snap is generally good, but or maybe it's just a Seagate Oracle instead of the snap. Now let's try that. Yeah. I mean, it was probably an early concession. I maybe could have clawed back, but that was just such a huge misplay that it's like, it's kind of embarrassed to keep playing after that. All right, his hand's great. I'll lead off the Sanctuary just to get the blue source in play. And then, depending on if I draw another land, I'll preordain or play a Nature's Chain even. I draw a land and he plays like Darksteel, then I will Nature's Chant, or I will not Nature's Chant. If he plays like a Seed of the Synod or something like that, then I'll just chant his land. Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna chant that. Doesn't matter what I draw, I'll just chant it. Ooh, that's pretty sweet. It's a badass draw. It can be kind of wasteful, but if he's on like a one or a two laner, that's a really good play. Alright, land. Sweet. So here. Maybe should preordain first. But, you know, I'm just gonna play a familiar and then preordain. Faithful on an island. I don't think I need another faithful, but. I'll take another island. I need an Ash Barrens now. That would be the best draw. Ash Barrens are just flat mountain. Okay, so he's on frog mites. Drew a snap. Then play Faithful, snap, and then play Deepnalysis. Let's do that. Don't really want to snap that thing. I don't think I do. Actually, I'm just going to cast Deepnalysis right here. Do need to find my mount for this guy, though. Hopefully he plays another shamanable land. Alright, Thoughtcast, that's a thing. Cool, cool. Oh, come on, Red Source. Lead off the Deepnalysis. Preordain. Still looking for the Red Source. Neither of those were. Yeah, I gotta keep her a bit. Don't I? Yeah, I think I do. So leave up double prohibit. Kind of glad I did. Okay, Mirror Enforcer. I'll snap that on my turn. Generate some mana. So snap the Mirror Enforcer. Bounce, bounce. We're on tap, on tap. Deep Analysis. Come on, Ash Barons. Sweet. Alright. So let's get a Red Source. Play Grillin' Shaman and force him to concede. All right, on to game three. Run it back the same way. Yeah, this is good. I think Callie's gonna be happy. Keep this. All right, looks like he's probably on a pretty fast start. Mold to six. No, wow, he's just got nothing. That's pretty sweet. We'll fetch an island. Preordain. Well, I'm gonna take the shaman for sure. We'll fetch a mountain with the evolving wilds and play shaman, just kill him. Oh no, he had the Dark Steel. That sucks. and a frogmite. Double sucks. Still gonna fetch him that one. I think here I'm going to snap the forger and counter it on the way back down. Yeah. Try and bait him out to play another, just replay it and then play another land I can blow up with the monkey. Fetch white. We play faithful, monkey, and then blow up two lands. Pretty good. Even if he has a Galvanic Blast here, that's fine. I've set him back a lot. And if he flings his Frogmite at the monkey, that's even better. I guess he's not doing that. Maybe. Just playing a Forger. That's cool. I'm perfectly okay with him playing a Forger. So monkey would take 3 mana to blow up this drum. Alright. I'm okay with that. So we'll blow up the drum. Just remove even more access to mana from him. It also takes his forger down to a 2-2. He's so good. Alright, come on. Nothing? He's not even gonna go blast me. Okay. You're gonna attack in, that's fine. Maybe you can get your attack in, buddy. Quark Clan. Ooh, that's pretty nice. I wonder if he's gonna sack all three. No, just the Frogmite. That's fine. So we can put... I'm just gonna put Preordain back on top. So, cast some Deep Analysis. I don't want to tap. I guess I can leave the red open and just one blue. Snap his forger, untap two blue. We'll just cast Deep Analysis. And blow up his land. Can't do anything if they don't have any resources. Frogmite. Prism. Prism's a good draw, actually. From him. For him. Alright, let's dig for familiars, Maldrifters, D deep analysis. Monkeys. I want a monkey here. That's close. I'll put the monkey on top and then a sanctuary on top. And is it gonna put remove soul on top? And then I'll preordain, get the remove soul in my hand. This protects me from Mirror Enforcer if he draws another land. Which he did, but no Mirror Enforcer. So, monkey. I can blow up his land and his prism. That's pretty good. This will just blow up his land first. And then if he doesn't do anything on his turn, I'll blow up the prism. Okay, taps for blue. Let's move to the next phase. I can use the blue. We'll blow up his prism now. Mole Drifter. Familiar's pretty good to draw too. So at this point I just need Mole Drifter Flicker. Did I take out Sage's Wrath? Not sure. Yeah, I took out Sage's Wrath, so I should be attacking. Oopsie. Alright, get in there for one. Snap is pretty good to protect the monkey. It's on a 20 turn clock until I draw, you know, things that attack. That's not a thing that attacks. Seven cards and no Mole Drifter. Alright, well that'll get me to a Mole Drifter faster, I assume. Cast the Mole Drifter. And I've got the Flicker. I don't think there's any need to do anything else this turn. I could just Flicker to fill up my hand. Take my hand up to 7 cards. Maybe he'll just concede when he sees this. I mean, this is actually just the win here. Because this is infinite life. But no sense in wasting time. I'm just going to attack and play lands and stuff until he dies. Sure, he You can have Chromatic Star. That doesn't matter. So blow this up. Counter the Mirror Enforcer. Prohibit the Dispel. Fill my hand. Another island. Really cute that he's making me play it out, though. By cute, I mean annoying. Get this to a two turn clock, hopefully. Yeah, I'll take the other flicker instead, though. No, I'll kill him in three turns instead of two, that's fine. Okay, sure. Sideboard plan for Affinity worked. 2-0 going into round 3. Oh, man. Oops. Whoopsie.
Ooh. Bit of silence, we're waiting for the next round here. I guess I can pull up the deck list instead of the timing thingy. Oh, of course. Pull the deck list and immediately get paired. Alright. I think he's on fairies. He's on fairies and get a couple lands. His hand's good. Eh, no. It's too slow. Let's get rid of it. Alright, this is better. Plays Burn in Affinity. Okay. Burn in Affinity, huh? Okay, thanks. I'll turn up my volume. From 17.1 to 12. Let's try that. Oh, your internet volume was low? Okay. It's gonna 15. Let's jam out a faithful. I'm gonna jam out another faithful. Okay, he's on affinity. We can snap and brainstorm. Oh my god. Alright. Brainstorm locking myself out when he has a Carapace Forger in hand is I'm not gonna win that game. Yeah, snap concede. Oh, that's right. I'm gonna do this last time. I think I cut deep analysis. Brainstorm. I don't know, maybe we shouldn't be playing Brainstorm. Maybe we should play Ponder. That doesn't, I'm sure that wouldn't have happened often. I think I was dead either way there. I need to make one more cut. Oh yeah, I cut Flicker last time. Alright. Oh, god, this sucks. I mean, I don't want to keep it. But it just sucks having Monkey and Faithful on Plains. Yeah, I mean, I'm keeping it for sure. It just means that I'm gonna have to fetch a blue with this Barons. I got a draw step, maybe I draw Island. Navigator's compass. Hey! I drew the mountain, that's sweet. Alright, so fetch our blue. Preordain. Oh, no frogs. Okay. I could keep both lands here. Because I'm going to Mold Drifter. Okay, podcast.
I just saw a YouTuber play one of my favorite games.
Oh, okay.
Infection H2.
Oh.
Maybe the second one. Because somehow the box got deleted the first. So then.
Alright, so I'm gonna jam out monkey here. What do you think, Logan? Should I play out the monkey?
Huh?
Should I play the monkey? What do you think?
Yeah.
You just play the monkey?
Yeah.
Alright, my son says I should play the monkey, so I'm gonna play the monkey.
Thanks, monkey. Can you switch up Infection Ink too?
What?
Can you switch up Infection Ink too?
Infection Ink too?
Uh-huh.
Oh, he had the gout blast. Oh man, and he had no land. Okay, whatever, that's fine. Oh hey, there's another monkey. I got the monkey and I can snap. For whenever he tries to kill it. No, I think he just conceded. Cool. Sorry, my son is home from school, so. I guess I keep this and hope to draw Monkey Boy. Yeah, I mean, it's just so good. Like, what do they do against? They can't even do anything against Monkey. So I think I just play Wilds here and fetch red. Yeah, I was gonna say, at least I have Prohibit and Snap. So. Just fetch red just so I have it. Oh, cool. I got a blue blast too. That's pretty sweet. Leave up Prohibit and blue blast. Alright. I think we'll snap the Forger now. Now I need to play Prism. I counted the Prism, really? Alright. Yeah, that's true. I'm thinking about his colors. Oh. Fun and fair magic. I feel kind of bad for my affinity opponents, honestly. Oh no, he had the gout blast. That sucks. Yeah, we're just gonna Evoke Drifter here. And I can't even counter an Atog.
I'm preordaining some more cards. I need to make sure I have my lands. Top or top of the island and bottom of the barrens. I think I'm gonna keep the island and bottom of the barrens. What do you think, Kelly? Yeah. That was deep analysis. Okay, got the familiar. It's a good deal. And then drew the remove soul. Oh man, he gets his colors now. Lucky bastard. Alright, so play the familiar. Snap the forger. Untap those. Play the faithful. Go. Goodbye, forger. You get no soul, good sir. Oh man, I guess he does get a soul. Okay. Alright. Deep analysis. Yeah, I mean, that's not what the forgers, or what the blue blast is for, but blue blast is specifically just to kill Atog, really. So, I mean, I'm not upset about that getting countered. Alright, let's play a Plains, Sunscape, Deep Analysis. I'm just gonna snap the forger, I think. I'm gonna snap the forger, play Deep Analysis again. Yeah, I mean, he's tapped out now. He's only got one card in hand. So I'll cast. Then I'll just cast Deep Analysis. Alright, cool. There's the monkey, and that should seal up the game next turn. Oh man, actually, Gearseeker's pretty rough. I mean, I do have a flicker, so I can block it indefinitely, but. Ugh. Stupid blue blast. Monkey, blow up four lands, leave up blue blast. Probably the play here. Nope, he just conceded. That game wasn't over. Like, he could have attacked with this 5/6 a couple of times. I mean, I didn't have a way out of it just yet. But I'll take it. Fuck it. I think Monkey has turned this match from, like, the worst matchup to I'm pretty happy to see it now. I think I'm probably gonna cut a blue blast for a remove soul. I lost to it last night when I was playing this deck. But I just drew just a shit ton of lands, so Yeah, yeah. I think the seventh fetch makes it much easier to not run Karus. I don't know how you've been sideboarding, because I think I was sideboarding. I think you cut Seagates because they just don't do anything. I think I have like one Seagate post board. So I cut Seagates and Sage's Row, cut the Strands, cut the Brainstorm, and then like one Deep Analysis. And then I bring in the Remove Souls, the Chance, three Shamans, and three Blasts. Yeah, no, I think you need Deep Analysis against them, because their thought casts just gain them so much advantage that you really need to be able to counter their advantage. And you need to be able to find the monkey, especially on like turn 6, 7, etc. I'm against. This hand's not keepable. Guess I'll keep this. Yeah, I'll write it down. I'll write it down later for later. I think he's on fairies. Not sure though. I think he plays a lot of different stuff. I'll throw back a deep analysis because I already got one. Yeah, I think four deep analysis is too clunky for them, and but you need some number of them to outcard them. Planes. Heroic. Alright. That's interesting. I guess I'll fetch a planes here. Yeah, I mean, I know to press like one, it's just don't normally do that. Yes, usually I will yield until they're in step to fetch. But I like bluffing force spike and stuff, because they don't know what I'm on. Sometimes they won't just jam out a turn one gun band if they think I'm on something else. So debating here whether I play the Sanctuary or Faithful. I think given that he's on Heroic, I think I need to dig. I need to dig for Strands. So I'm going to play the Sanctuary and then play the Seagate next turn. He's got a really, really, really aggressive start, too. Didn't hit it there. That sucks. I'm gonna chump. Keep my life total as high as possible. think next turn is probably Faithful Evoke Muldrift turn. Did I play melee on that turn? I hope I did. I think I did. Okay. So he's got this guy. So I'm gonna take 7 here. At the least. Yeah. Yeah, I have to block this guy. It's just fine. Yeah. I take 7. Yeah, it's another pump spell, so I'm gonna take 8 or 9 here. 10. Take 10. So I'm dead next turn. And Faithful and Mortuary Mire. To play Faithful, Mortuary Mire, the Moldrifter to the top. Faithful, fetch Sage's Rune. Makes sense. Yeah, because that turns on Sanctuary. He has the protection spell. I'm dead. No. Yeah. I think I'm dead either way if he has the protection spell. But you're right. That's probably the best line there. Because if he gives this guy pro white and then makes the Sage's Rope block the Deathblade, then he'll lose. Okay. He's hexproof and indestructible. Sure. Not sure why he's doing that right now. So the correct line for him here is just play Merge Unscathed or his Cho Manos or whatever the heck it is. Yeah. You're probably right. He probably punted. Just chump of the faithful here. I think. Yeah, because I think that one Boros mana instant only gives double strike, I only gives trample. Yeah, I was just thinking whether I need a double block, but I don't think that instant gets trample. I
I could just drift her here instead of deeping. So if I drift her and draw untap land and strands, then that protects me. If I don't, then I just play Faithful and pass. Yeah. Makes sense. You know, I actually probably should have Sage's Rose myself. Oh, well, I drew the strands. But actually, in hindsight, I should have Sage Rose myself. Yeah, so if I survive this turn, I'm good to go. I wasn't thinking about the Sage Row Yourself plan. I haven't been playing with strands in a while, so I forgot about all the cool things you can do with strands. Alright, so I'm still dead if he has the Emerge plus anything else. Okay, third alarm on that guy, that doesn't matter. I mean, I guess he's gonna provoke my Faithfuls or something? I don't know. It's a bit odd of a play. I don't think I'd have made that one. I guess unless he plans on... I mean, he is gonna kill my Sage's Row. Yeah. Let's see, actually. No, if he has an instant that pumps this, I die if I don't jump it, so I'm gonna jump it. Alright, so we survived. It's pretty cool. Can't cast Mold Drifter, but I can cast Deep Analysis, so let's do that. Cards in with no familiar. That sucks. Alright, Defiant Strike, sure. Third Armor, okay. No point in bluffing now, so I'm just gonna strands. So we go Faithful. Deep Analysis. Deep Analysis again. Right now.
preordain. Cool. I think I will take both of these. Then put preordain back on top. And then deep analysis again. Twenty-five cards in, no familiars. Yeah, he almost certainly does have the protection against the snap, but I'm not gonna play around that. Oof, man, 13 cards? That sucks. Alright, so now even if he does have the protection from the snap, we got the prohibit. So let's snap this dude. Alright, so there's his protection spell. Now I probably should preordain first. Yeah. No, you're right. I said it. And you're right. Hey, there's the familiar. Just cast the deep analysis. Yeah. Cast deep analysis. He's gonna he gets to kill my familiar. That sucks. But I've got another familiar, so that's pretty good. Preordain again. Bottom, I'll top the prohibit. Yeah, no, it's fine. I caught it late too. I should have preordained. I thought about that too, but I was kind of so eager to snap and show off my prohibit skills with snap. Yeah, I'm gonna counter an ethereal armor for sure. Yes, welcome to the chat room. I think my page is refreshed. So play familiar here. I have 6-7 mana. I can Drifter, Deep Analysis. Brainstorm. Nah. Cast Drifty Boy. You know, snap. Can snap this and hope he doesn't have a protection spell. Even if it does have protection spell, it's not the worst for me. I'm just gonna snap it. Oh, cool. He didn't. It's pretty sweet. Why would I wait for his turn to do that? Then he gets protection and he gets to attack, too. And force, like, the Muldrifter and the Sunscape to block. Bring in Nature's Chant. Maybe Scattershot. And I suppose it doesn't matter either way, but I don't know, I like using my... Whenever my snaps can generate mana, I like using snaps on my turn. Probably don't need Sage's Row. Oh yeah, that makes sense. Seagates are probably not needed. Yeah, bring in... some negates or some ruin souls. Probably negates are good. Got a lot of protection spells. I hate brainstorm. I'm gonna cut that from the list for sure.
Alright. This seems fine. What about that? I'm on the draw, but I've got two Faithfuls, Prohibit, Snap. I don't like this flicker, but... I'm gonna keep it. It's sketchy, but I think I'm gonna keep it. If he doesn't have, yeah, he doesn't have turn one Legata Band. That's really good for me. This deck is like completely non-functional without turn one Legata Band. Yeah, like this guy is just nothing. I'll play Faithful here. Nah, I kind of want him to pump this Skyguard thing. Oh man, he's gonna give protection from blue though. That sucks. Oof. Yeah. Alright, well that was a big misplay then, I guess. Was not anticipating the Cho Manos. I guess I'll play Faithful and hold up Prohibit. So I need to draw like a Nature's Chant pronto. Or, yeah, we're definitely prohibiting that. Alright, negates get draw. Just pass turn again. Negate is play, and then probably have to go for like a Muldrifter next turn. Yeah, you're probably right. No, I think you're right before too. I think I probably should have snapped and left up prohibit the next left, like turn two. Instead of just playing out that. Or just left up prohibit slash snap. Alright. Well, now I'm forced to do this. And then hope he doesn't have a pump spell, I suppose. Or draw preordain. Alright, well, if he has a pump spell in it, then I survive. He'll just negate it. Oh, yeah, you're right. Journey to nowhere. You'll just snap the faithful that he targets with this. We need to draw like exactly Prismatic Strands survive, I think. Deep analysis, draw two. One of those two is Prismatic Strands, I believe. The hell? I'll shoot a disconnect. No, I didn't. Yeah, no, I'm dead. Alright, yeah, that turn two misplay. Failed. I think it's fine, I just... The Cho Manos just wrecked me. And not drawing the strands also kind of wrecked me too. Yeah, I'm keeping this. All right. Come on. Turn. My planes. Ch- chain out sunscapes. Deathblade Elite. And he's on a one lander. Sweet. Play Sunscape Snap. No possible play Heal Ball. Okay. Journey to Nowhere. Oh, okay. That's a cool play. I should have done that. No, that's cool. I knew you were going to say something. I just didn't know what you were going to. I think I was set on what I was going to do anyway. I'll do that next play, though. That's pretty sweet. Oh my god, another familiar? Thank you. So now we evoke Drifter. I like that play. I'm going to use that in the future, for sure. And then Mire the Drifter. Oh, okay, I see that. That's sweet. I don't think I've ever used that option. That is badass, though. Oh man, he's got that thing. It's annoying. I think I have to kill my familiars. Yeah, we are not doing it. That's funny. So I can either just cast Drifter here and leave familiar in my hand. Sanctuary tapped. Yeah. What I was thinking. Just cast Drifter. Play Sanctuary. Next turn, probably put Sanctuary on top. Or probably put Snap on top with Sanctuary. Why is he attacking with Standard Bearer? Oh, okay. That makes sense. I just don't know why he's making me jump with Drifter instead of the familiar. So what do you think? I think I probably want to put Snap on top, Preordain into it, and then Snap his Deathblade. Maybe even just, yeah, I need to Snap his Deathblade. I think. Oh no, I have to Snap the Standard Bearer. Yeah, no, I have to Snap the Standard Bearer, so. Okay. Yeah. Let's preordain into something. Preordain Snap.
Let's do roll first.
Alright, I think I need Strands at this point. So I'm gonna bottom the Snap. Top preordain. Logan, volume. Jesus. I guess I'll keep the prohibit. Keep the prohibit and not die, I guess. Bottom of the prohibit? I don't know. Yeah, you're right. Just nothing. Alright, I'll put a priority on top and then play a familiar. Yeah, probably. Probably. What did you provoke? I didn't see which one provoked. Okay, he provoked that one. No, no, I'm not gonna block. He has Karametris Blessing. Up, Gustavo. Alright, so I need like Strands and Flicker and card draw. I need a lot of stuff to live here. This sucks. Unfortunately, familiar is not it. Jesus. Just stone cold nothing. Damn it, man. I'm gonna hit another one loss league. Now, you know what? I should have fetched the red there. Doesn't matter. Damn. Yeah, this sucks. This is game three. Yep, that's game. That sucks. Strands is way far down too. Alright, well. Yeah, that sucks. I just Deathblade wrecked me. I couldn't really draw anything. And then I couldn't even snap the Standard Bearer. I couldn't even snap it because of Standard Bearer. All eyes on me, usually on Tron. His hand is unkeepable. His hand is also unkeepable. Good luck. Later, Gally, thanks. Keep this. Yeah, no, it's fine. Whoops. Nah, I tried to delay sometimes, but... Okay, he's not on Tron. It's interesting. Seal of Fire. You helped me make a couple plays that were good. Which way am I on? I'll take the Mortuary Mire in this case. Looks like he's on Bully. I'll just play the mountain in deep analysis, or I can sunscape. No, I can't protect the sunscape, so I'll just play the mountain in deep analysis. Cool. Sunscape and prohibit. Two sunscapes and prohibit are pretty good draws. We'll just play Sunscape, cast Deep Analysis, looking for an untapped island. Didn't get it. So I'll just play another Sanctuary. Discard for Prismatic Strands. It's interesting. I assume this is a Palace Sentinels. Yep. And there's the untapped island. So, familiar, do some analyze deeply. Give up snap prohibit now. Rally the Peasants. I think I can snap a Squadron Hawk here. Three, 6, 9. That's 2, 13. It's not lethal. I think I'll just prohibit this. This probably means he's gonna kill one of my familiars. Or just play land and flash it back. Yeah. Okay, well, this game went south really, really fast. Can snap and steal the monarchy. Mortuary Mire, put Sunscape on top. Leave up snap. Stay faithful. Preordain. I don't know if this is the correct line of play here. Sunscape, C8. Bottom this, top this. I think I actually need to snap Squadron Hawk. Yeah, so snap Squadron Hawk. He has another Rally, I'm dead either way, I think. Sure. That's the same basic effect, so I'm cool with that. So he flashes back Rally, I take 3-6. He has another Rally, I take another 4. Okay. Rough. Why did you do that with the Squadron Hawk? That doesn't make any sense. You should have done that with Palace Sentinels. I think here we put snap on top. Maybe we put prohibit on top. Yeah, I think we put prohibit on top. Where's the snap? Play familiar, evoke drifter, flicker drifter, and the sanctuary. Okay. Yeah, no, we put prohibit on top. So fam. We hope he doesn't have a bolt, obviously. Evoke Drifter. Why can I not? Oh, shit. That was an idiot. It's gonna work out, but I was like, why can't I flicker right now? Okay. So we'll prohibit his rally. Block is appropriate. Unless he's not planning on rallying. So there's a rally. Prohibit it. And hope he doesn't have another. Okay, I think it's time. So I think it's time for shenanigans. Let's cycle. Grab an island. Play the island. I'm going to snap the Mulder tree. He's going to try and respond by seal of firing it. Fine, because I'll just flicker Muldrifter and Sanctuary. He's got a bolt. Okay, I'll just flicker Muldrifter and Sanctuary. Now we will, I think, flicker two sanctuaries to put two flickers back on top, or maybe a flicker and a prohibit back on top. Cast Deep Analysis. Snap one of the birds. Do I want to flicker again? No, I don't need to flicker again. Last turn like that. Looting, okay, cool. More birds. More burbs. It's fine. End of the looting. Yeah, I don't care about a three-bird inspector. So here I can just put two flickers on top. I think I want to do that. Flicker Drifter Sanctuary. Draw two flickers. Flicker Drifter Sanctuary.
Looking for another familiar with the infinite. Prismatic Strands is pretty good though. Flicker Drifter Sanctuary. Come on, familiar. In the meantime, just drawing a ton of, or skinning a ton of life. Okay, there's a Faithful. I'm actually going to play the Faithful here, I think. Oh, actually no, I'm going to keep flickering until... Okay, so I got one more flicker and then I'm just going to have Strands up. That is assuming I don't draw the familiar here. Yeah, okay, I'm just going to leave Strands up here. Strands up plus Prohibit. I don't think he still has his hawk in his hand. Just strands him if he attacks, and then should be able to draw into the last familiar this turn. Yeah, I probably should have flickered at the end of his turn. No big deal, but I should have done it. Okay. So let's... Whoops. Not white. Evoke Drifter. Alright, there's the familiar. Cool. Flicker, Drifter, Sanctuary. Draw the deck. Just looking for Sage's Row to close this out. Come on, Sage's Row, where are you? Damn it. Bottom. Bottom. Jesus Christ. What's up, Nabu? I think the Sage's Row was actually just literally the bottom card of my deck before I did those preordains. There we go. There he is. Alright, so now I've got to Seagate Sanctuary Flicker. Alright, well thank you for to all eyes for conceding there. Because that was going to be pretty rough if we hadn't. Like negates against them. I don't know what to cut though. The red is for Gorilla Shaman. Makes Affinity a lot better. Scattershot for all the birds. Probably Nature's Chant. I think sea gates don't matter that much. Cutting the brainstorm because I hate brainstorm. And just one snap. Oh, all right. Seems keep. Barely? Eh, maybe it wasn't a keep. I'm gonna fetch blue with the wilds. Yeah, it's rough. I mean, it's taken me a while to learn it. A lot of leagues.
Logan.
Damn it. All right, so he played Inspector. So preordain. I already have a Maul Drifter on top of the Sanctuary, though. Fetch another island. Let's go. Faithful, Wilds, bottom of the Wilds, top of the Faithful. If Faithful, play Island, go. Same play, Faithful, except in this case I think I want to play the Sanctuary. Let's go. Thank you. Fetch an island. Hoping to strands him next turn. So imagine he's gonna go for a rally here. Maybe not though. I think I'm going to evoke Drifter. But basically only because I drew the other one. Okay, cool. Good draws there. Let's play the Plains. I think regardless of what he does next turn, I'm going to Strands. On his block step. I care if it does that. I mean, as well. I think this makes him keep applying more and more pressure. Really annoying that he still has strands. Why does he still have strands in his deck? That doesn't make any sense. Like, did he not have something better to bring in than strands? Frustrating. Okay. If he's spending his bolts on my faithfuls, I'm pretty happy with that. Chant. I should play the mountain and left open the white and blue. Because now if he has rally, I'm just dead. Looks like he chose not to do that. It's interesting. All right. I think I need to Mortuary Mire Faithful, actually. Cast Deep Analysis. Actually, no, I can't cast Deep Analysis. Well, no, I can. I can only Deep Analysis and Strands. And leave up Strands. Which is fine. Okay. Leave up Strands. Cast Faithful next turn. Oblivion Ring? Okay. I need to take a drop of wheels off of that. So he doesn't have rally because he would have gone for it there. Okay. Okay, I did not take out Denison. That's good. Let's play Faithful. Play some Deep Analysis. Play land. Leave this up. I can Nature's Chant the Oblivion Ring at the end of his turn. Prohibit. Whatever. Maybe it's Nature's Chant now. It's Nature's Chant now. Alrighty. So, fam. Bam. Analysis. It's past turn this time. Flashback strands and, prohibit any burn spells. Probably prohibit a set of Palace Sentinels too. Yeah, let's just prohibit Palace Sentinels. Play the Faithful. He's gonna just snap a Squadron Hawk for life. Yeah, let's cast Deep Analysis first. See if we get a combo. No, but I got a basic island, so that's probably good enough. Deep Analysis again. It's only costing me one life. Might have a bolt here, which is fine. We will negate that. Five storm, but he's got that stupid Prismatic Strands. Alright, Deep Analysis again. Okay, so there's the infinite combo. We got 4 minutes to finish it. That should be enough, I think. I might actually have to wait a turn to do the combo. Because I played out that island earlier. So, and also I boarded out the Seagate Oracle, so. Alright. So, I'm going to top both of these. I'm actually just going to pass turn. Because I'm going to mill myself out if I try to do the combo this turn. Strands. Snap. Strands. Snap. Island. Familiar. Drifter. Scattershot. I don't need that right now. Gonna be tight on time. Okay, so let's put the gate on top. We'll flicker two sanctuaries. Come on, Allies, don't time me out, bro. Flicker two more sanctuaries. Thank you. Really scummy, all eyes. Really scummy. I used respect to you. This is pretty fucking scummy now. Super scummy. I win this if he didn't fucking scum me.